What if the reason Excel VBA feels so frustrating has nothing to do with VBA at all? I used to struggle with the VBA editor and it hurt my head. But over the years, I've picked up some powerful secrets that make it much easier to use the VBA editor. So in this video, I'll share 5 time-saving hacks that I wish someone had shown me when I just got started. Hack number 1 is called Turbo Teleportation. Do you ever feel like you're endlessly scrolling through VBA code and it's stealing your life away? Well, instead of wasting time with a scroll, how about instantly jumping around your code, just like teleporting from one place to another? Ding me up, Scotty. Here's Excel. Let's open the VB editor using the shortcut Alt and F11. Now look at the top. There are these 2 dropdowns, left and right. This one on the left shows your objects. It could be worksheets, forms, or modules, but it's the dropdown on the right that holds the magic. You can see it lists every procedure in the module. So if you click on a name, boom, you're taken instantly there. But here's where it gets interesting. These procedures are listed alphabetically in the dropdown, which can be different from the order they appear in the code window. So if you want to move through the code in the order your procedures are written without using your mouse to scroll, simply press Control and down arrow to jump to the next procedure, and Control and up arrow to go back to the previous one. Thus, you can press Ctrl and End to teleport straight to the bottom of the code module, and Ctrl and Home to teleport straight up to the top. Not only that, if you hold Shift when you move around using the arrow keys and Control keys, you can select your code as you move. Do you want even more focus? Look at the bottom left corner of the editor. There are 2 tiny buttons. The one on the left is for Procedure View, and the one on the right is for Module View. By default, we're in the module view, so we can see everything in the current module. But if we select procedure view, we see just one procedure at a time, so we can't scroll accidentally into other subroutines. It's clean, focused, and calm. And you can continue to use control and up arrow to move up, or control and down arrow to move down between procedures. Now here's where things get really fun. Hit control and F6, and you instantly switch between open code windows. So I'm going to press control and F6 again, Control and F6. And if you want to close the current one, just press Control and F4. And you can keep pressing Control and F4 to close more windows. And if you're working on a big project, you can temporarily bookmark lines in blue. And this marks important spots. Just make sure you have the Edit toolbar visible. So if you can't see this, right-click on the menu area and then select Edit. So we can add bookmarks, jump to the next bookmark, jump to the previous bookmark, and I'm going to add a bookmark in another module. Let's put it on this line. Click on Toggle Bookmark. Then we can use Next Bookmark to move between the different modules. No more losing your place. But just bear in mind that these bookmarks disappear when you close the file. So to get around this, you can add comments that say Bookmark 1 or BM1. And then you can use Control F to search for BM or bookmark in the current project, and you want a matched case. When you find next, it will highlight the bookmark. But there's one situation where all these shortcuts still don't help. Just picture this. You open a workbook you haven't touched in 6 months, and you find this. And your brain goes, wait, what does that do? Why did I write this? Is it safe to delete? Now imagine you'd written this instead. Much clearer. And that's the power of a well-written comment block. It gives your future self instant clarity. But here's the reality. Most people don't do it. Why? Because it feels like a chore. You've just wrestled with logic and syntax to write the code. The last thing you want to do is write a mini manual. So you skip it thinking, I'll do it later. Except later never comes. And that's why I recommend hack number 2, instant comments. Here's some VBA code I wrote before. I'll simply head to my favorite AI, which right now is ChatGPT 04 Mini, and enter this prompt using the dictate feature. I'm writing Excel VBA macros and want to generate clean, professional comment blocks for each sub-procedure. Please analyze the following VBA procedure and return a concise comment block formatted for pasting directly above the code. Now I'll hit Shift and Enter for new lines. Go back to the VBA editor. Press Ctrl A to select all of my code. Press Ctrl C to copy it. Then head back in to ChatGPT and press Ctrl V to paste the code. Now I'll submit the request, and while we let AI do its magic, we'll see just how much code there was. See, there's a significant chunk of code there. So it thought for 5 seconds and it created this. And I can copy this head back to the VB editor, and Control V to paste it. Boom! Instant clarity. No time tax, no excuses, just a nice comment block to keep your code easy to read. So I've included this prompt and all the other hacks from this video inside the downloadable workbook. You can get it from the link below. And since we're talking about comments, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Which of these hacks do you already know? And do you have a favorite VBA tip that you want to share? Drop a comment below. I read every single one. And if you're finding this video useful, make sure you subscribe because I've got more VBA goodies coming your way. Let's move on to hack number 3, tap to toggle. This one is a personal favorite. Say you've got a line of code that sends 300 emails and you're not quite ready for that chaos until you've tested the rest of the procedure. We can comment out one line of code easily. Just add an apostrophe to the start of the line and now you've stopped that line of code from running. But what if you need to comment out a big chunk of code? Adding an apostrophe to each line one at a time takes absolutely ages. So let me show you how to do it in an instant. First, make sure you've got the edit toolbar visible. If you can't see it, right click on the VB editor menu area and toggle edit so it's checked. You'll see these two little buttons. This one here is comment block and this one here is uncomment block. So all you need to do is select some code and then click on comment block to comment it out. And if you want to uncomment it, select the code and click on uncomment block. Done. But I prefer keyboard shortcuts because they're better for when we're writing code as our hands are already on the keyboard. And I want a more descriptive toolbar because those buttons are a bit too small. So let's create our own custom toolbar for instant comment control. So I'll right click on the menu area, then click on customize, and I'll click on toolbars, then new. Give it a custom name, just call it custom. Click OK. And you see it floats around, but we can dock it into the menu area here. There's nothing inside it, so it looks blank. Now head to commands, and we'll choose edit. And inside the edit commands, scroll down until you see comment block, and you can click and drag this into position. The same for uncomment block, click and drag it into position. Now don't stop there, because what we need to do is add labels. So right click on comment block, and you'll see down here, it's default style, but we want image and text. So click that, and we'll do the same for uncomment block. So right click, then click on image and text, and we can add a shortcut by right clicking, and in front of the C of comment block, I'll type in an ampersand. So that ampersand means we press Alt plus this key C as a shortcut. And we'll do the same for uncomment block. So right click, and at the beginning of comment block, I will type in an ampersand. So Alt and U, ampersand U, that will be the shortcut. Now we're done. We can close the customize menu and we'll test it out. I'll select this text. I can now press Alt U to uncomment it. There we go, it's uncommented. And select it again. Press Alt C to comment it. Ta-da! Now you've got keyboard control over comments, but what if you want to slow your code down and watch it work line by line? That's what hack number 4 is all about. I call it debug like a detective. Imagine you're Sherlock Holmes investigating the mysterious behavior of a macro. You take out your magnifying glass and start your detective work. Let's start our next investigation. We'll run the sub start investigation by clicking on the first line and pressing F5. When I do this, you'll see the immediate window immediately pops up. So it looks like something happened, but we didn't see what because it happened so fast. To crack the case, we're going to have to work methodically and go through this one line at a time. So I'll close the immediate window for now and then place the cursor at the beginning of the subroutine. Then instead of pressing F5, I want to press F8. And you see this yellow line of highlighting and it shows what line of code is going to run next. Every time I press F8, it moves on to the next line. This first line actually opens the immediate window by sending the Control G shortcut. There we go, the immediate window's popped up. This next line sets the progress variable to 0. Press F8, done. Then we use debug.print to send this line of text into the immediate window. So every time I press F8, it's like a frame by frame slow motion replay, F8. I can wait as long as I like before pressing F8 again. La 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 la, F8. And this makes it much easier to track down bugs as we're in code detective mode. F8. Whoa, there goes a bug. Catch it. If we want to, we can just keep pressing F8 until we get to the end of the procedure. F8, F8, F8. I'll keep pressing the F8, and so on. More F8s. So I'm almost at the last line, and this line sends Control G, Control A, and Delete, which clears the immediate window. So I'll press F8, and F8 again, and now the yellow highlighting goes away because our code has finished running. But what happens if our main sub is calling another sub that we trust, and we just don't want to run it line by line? Well, you can choose to step over it. So I'll start running this sub with F8, and then keep pressing F8 until I get to that line. And instead of running room 1, which is down here, I'm going to press Shift and F8 to step over it. So you can see up here that the room 1 code actually did run, but we're straight on this line, so we didn't have to step through all of the code line by line. So I'm going to press F8 to run that line, and then I'm going to press Shift F8 to step over the call to room 2. So again, you can see that the code for room 2 did run, so all of this code did run here, but we've gone straight to the next line, so we didn't have to step through all of this code one by one. And we can now keep pressing F8 till we finish. And finally, what if we just want to run all the code up to a specific line without having to keep pressing F8? So let's start the investigation by pressing F8. Then let's click on this last debug print line. It's the line we want to stop at. And we go up to debug and click on run to cursor or press Control and F8. So we immediately fast forwarded over all this code and landed straight on this last debug print line. And if you ever need to stop the investigation early for a tea or coffee break, just click on Run to open the Run menu, and then click on Reset. That immediately stops the code so you can have your cup of tea or coffee. Plus, if you see yourself using this a lot, just right-click on the menu area and show the Debug toolbar. This has the Reset button right here for quick access. With these tools in hand, you're no longer just running code, you're solving a case, line by line, clue by clue, just like Sherlock. And if you want the full code to all the hacks in this video, check out the description and the link below. By the way, my name's Victor, and I've helped thousands of people go from dreading VBA to using it with confidence. Let me take a quick break to say that this video is part of my online course. It's called Excel Macros and VBA School, and it teaches how to automate Excel and cut repetitive work. Why would anyone want to check out my course? Well, this is what one of my students, Ivan, wrote. Victor is the most helpful IT person I've ever been in contact with. He goes more than the extra mile to assist you with any issue you have in learning about VBA. His methods are detailed with care to explain what each term in the script means. Money well spent. And over 500 people like Ivan have enrolled. Check out the description to find out more. Okay, break over. Let's get back into the Visual Basic Editor and I'll show you the next super useful tip. What if you know exactly where things might go wrong and you want your code to stop running right there, automatically? It's time for hack number 5, hit the brakes. Let's bring in breakpoints. Think of a breakpoint as a checkpoint for your code. You set it, the code runs, then it stops as soon as it reaches the checkpoint so you can inspect it.
I can't believe I'm doing traffic duty. I've got to get back to Excel.
So we click on the margin next to a line of code like this to set a breakpoint. So you'll see this red dot, and also the whole line is highlighted red. You can also set multiple breakpoints, so I'll add another one down here. Now, when we run this macro with F5, you immediately see it jumps to this point, that first breakpoint, and it highlights the code in yellow. So that's the code that's going to run next. And we can check variables like car ID by hovering over them, or we can try car speed. So I'll press F5 again, and it will keep running the code until it gets to this breakpoint again. So in this case, we're stuck inside this do loop until the car speed is greater than 80 miles an hour. So what if we want to monitor several variables at once, like car ID and car speed? We'll just click on this variable and press Shift F9. That brings up the quick watch window. And when we press add, you'll see this new watches window comes up and you can see the expression car ID with a value of 2 here. And we can do the same with car speed. I'll click on car speed, then I'll press Shift F9. Got a quick watch, we'll add that, and you see in the watches window, we can see car speed. You can also delete watches by right-clicking and deleting the watch. For now, we'll leave these two. So we'll keep hitting F5 to run the code. And so car 1 under the speed limit, car 2 under the speed limit, car 3, car 4 under the speed limit, car 5 cruising at 86.5 miles an hour. Okay, this is going over the speed limit. So what you'll notice is that we don't have to keep pressing F8, and we can check our code at fixed points. So we've got car 5 at 86.4844. So I'll keep running the code with F5, and it says speeding car detected. Car 5 stopped for inspection. And I'll press F5 again, and it will clear the immediate window. Now you can toggle breakpoints on and off by clicking in the margin here. But if you've got lots of breakpoints, you can go to the debug menu and click on clear all breakpoints or press Ctrl+Shift+F9. And now your code runs free. So we've seen how to use breakpoints and set up quick watches, but these aren't the only hacks you should use. I have 5 more game-changing secrets that even longtime VBA pros don't know. These next level secrets will save you hours of frustration and wasted effort. So watch the next video to see what they are and why they're so powerful.